These are the top 5 features coming to Apple TV this fall. With tvOS 18, there's brand new features like Insight, which gives you actor information and even tells you the music playing while you're watching something, dynamic subtitles that come on when you rewind or mute what you're watching, enhanced dialogue audio settings, updated screensavers, and more. You'll be able to try Insight with the public beta for tvOS 18, and it's coming out for everyone this fall. So let's jump into a hands-on preview of Insight. Insight is a new feature specifically available when you're watching Apple TV Plus original content. Now when you tap the back button or any of the arrow keys while you're watching something, you'll see a new Insight option next to Info and Up Next. There you'll see the current actors on screen. This is actually using Apple's machine learning technology to figure out the faces and audio that's playing. When you tap a specific actor, you'll then see more details about them, and you can see all the movies and shows that they've been in. Tap another actor and you can see their info, and you can even go up to the actor information, tap more, and read a short biography. This works not only when there's multiple people in a single scene, and if there's songs playing in the background. As you'll see, people are getting added to that Insight row as they appear on screen. You can click one to see more information, and you can add any song that's currently playing to your Apple Music library. If I tap this here, you'll see it's saved in the upper right-hand corner. Now if I go to the Apple Music app on my iPhone, and if it's the same iCloud account as the Apple TV profile, you'll see the song that I just added right here. Plus, it automatically created this playlist called Saved Songs, and these are all the songs that I've added using Insight on Apple TV. Unfortunately, this isn't going to work with non-Apple TV Plus original content. Here, this is Dune 2, which I did purchase through Apple on my Apple TV, but you'll see there's no Insight option under the play bar. Now, big feature number 2 is you actually don't have to look at the Insight information on the Apple TV screen. You can do it using the Apple TV Remote app on your iPhone. If I'm playing content where you see the Insight there on the Apple TV, you'll also now see in the Apple TV Remote, once you're running the iOS 18 public beta or the public release this fall, there's a new eye icon right here. If I tap that eye icon, I'll also see info for what I'm watching. I can see a new Up Next queue, all the TV shows or movies that I might have in my Up Next. And I can go to the Insight tab here, and I'll see the actors and actresses here, and any songs that might be playing also available down here. If I want to add that song to my Apple Music library, I can hit the plus icon right here from my iPhone and do that. I can also change what's on the Apple TV just by tapping here on the Up Next queue on my iPhone. So if I tap Dune Part 2 here, it's actually going to change it on my Apple TV. Love that quick access to the Up Next queue. You'll also see new skip back 10 second and skip forward 10 second options in the Apple TV Remote app. This is going to be especially useful because subtitles are enhanced with tvOS 18. Not only can you enable subtitles using this shortcut from the Apple TV Remote app, you'll see them appear right there on the screen, but even if you have subtitles off, if you mute the content on your Apple TV, subtitles will appear for about 10 seconds. Now when I tap mute, either on the Apple TV iPhone remote or my physical Apple TV remote, the subtitles will actually appear temporarily. Likewise, if you have subtitles off, but you go back a few seconds, maybe you didn't hear what they said, subtitles will temporarily turn on just for those 10 seconds. You'll see that in the bottom right corner, and then they will disable after those 10 seconds. So subtitles automatically on rewind and mute in tvOS 18. Number 4, there's new enhanced dialogue features in Apple TV. If you go over to the sound icon here, you'll see a new enhanced dialogue option. And here you have two choices. You can enhance the clarity of the dialogue and boost the volume. This is also going to work if you're wearing AirPods, if you're connected to a soundbar. The Apple TV will process that audio to whatever destination. And finally, number 5, we have new screensaver options here in tvOS 18. We have some new options for the Arial screensavers. You can choose what themes you want to show or hide, but we can also set up photos and slideshows and portraits as screensavers here on Apple TV. Once you choose to set up, you'll actually authenticate with an iOS device connected to your iCloud account, and now you'll see both portraits and photos are syncing to this Apple TV, and it's going to create screensavers automatically with my library content. Now when there's a screensaver playing, I can actually tap left and right on the Apple TV remote and go to a different Arial screensaver manually. I don't have to wait for it to automatically transition. And if you want to quickly go to the photo or portrait screensavers, I can swipe up or tap up on the Apple TV remote, and then I can quickly change over to photos and slideshows or my portrait images here. Once your iCloud photo library has synced, you can go into the portraits and then choose which people you would like to show, either your favorites or just hide people in general. I'll go with favorites. You can also choose to show pets, nature, and/or cities, and how often you want that to change. If I go into Photos and Slideshows, I can also choose all memories or just my favorited memories from my iCloud Photo Library, or I can select specific albums. I'm not quite sure how long it's going to take to process these, but I will update you once it's finished on more tvOS 18 features and iOS 18 and macOS Sequoia. So subscribe to the channel right here. If you have any questions about Apple TV or the iOS and macOS Sequoia, leave comments below this video. I'd love to answer you there. And I did a video on some of the lesser seen features in iOS 18. I'll link that video right up here. And if you're into shortcuts and automations, and there's some great changes coming to iOS 18, like with if statements and new actions, I'll put a video I did on that right up here. Plus, you can now put shortcuts on your lock screen in place of the flashlight and camera button, which is pretty slick. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next time.